وصلي وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله بعد. As you heard in the khutbah, we spoke about Uthman رضي الله تعالى عنه, the third خليفة. And Uthman specifically رضي الله تعالى عنه, as we mentioned, he was killed by the Khawarij. يعني سبحان الله, a strange incident happened in the Muslim Ummah. يعني a man, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم مثل يعني ألا استحي من رجل تستحي من ملائكة, a man of modest shyness, the angels feel shy from Uthman رضي الله, they killed him because of what? Because mainly of the rumors, سبحان الله. Yes, the bad intention, okay, some may be from the enemy of Islam, but one of the main reasons, brothers and sisters, the rumors. And take information without checking if it is authentic or not. So please, when you read the books, okay, this is any book about Islam, about medicine, politics, anything, try to make sure the information is authentic. But of course, the most important thing and most sensitive thing is Islam. This is hadith or not, authentic hadith or not. So subhanAllah, there were accusations to Uthman رضي الله تعالى عنه. They said, you killed Ammar ibn Yasir. Okay, and Ammar was alive رضي الله تعالى. You know, subhanAllah, sometimes it is very clear. This is very clear. Okay, you killed Uthman. Okay, sorry, you killed Ammar. Ammar was there. He was alive. No, you killed him and you stabbed him and you cut his abdomen and stomach and subhanAllah. Uthman is alive. يعني how I killed him, I did all of these things, and Ammar is alive. But people believe that, or some people believe that, subhanAllah. And also, as we mentioned the khutbah, he burned the masahif. Yes, this is correct, but why he did that? Okay, to protect the Muslim Ummah, to protect the Quran, and the other companions agreed with them. So ignorant people sometimes, ignorant people, accuse the scholars. Look, the scholars, what they say, what they do, and they are ignorant. Sometimes, subhanAllah, what we notice people who are ignorant, they don't come to the masjid, they don't practice Islam, maybe they are not praying, they criticize the scholars, and they criticize the du'at, they criticize our imam. Habibi, where are you? Do you know how to make wudu? He doesn't know how to make wudu. He picks something from the newspaper or from the media, from YouTube, and it starts to criticize the scholars, subhanAllah. So Uthman did that with the ijma' of the companions, consensus from the companions, and to protect the Muslim Ummah. And also they accused Uthman radiallahu ta'ala and that when he took the khilaf, when he became the khalifa, he gave good positions for his relatives from Bani Umayyah. This man for Kufa, this man for Isham, this man for SubhanAllah. يعني, is it compulsory for the leader to remove all of his relatives from the ministries? Okay? No. No one said that. You have to remove all of your relatives. And some of them, يعني, for example, Muawiyah from the same tribe, Bani Umayyah. And he was the leader of Isham before Uthman, رضي الله تعالى عنه. So if you want to accuse, you should accuse the one before him. And also, what was the mistake of Muawiyah رضي الله تعالى عنه that time? No mistake. Alhamdulillah, he was a good leader for Sham and he was just. Alhamdulillah. No, you accuse, this was your relative, this was your relative. And also the same thing, يعني, if you want to follow their concept, you should also accuse Ali رضي الله تعالى عنه. Also, he put some of his relatives. But this is not wrong. This is not a mistake. Not mistake for Uthman, not mistake for Ali رضي الله تعالى عنه. But subhanAllah, people read something and they believe. Until now, until this day, many Muslims, when they read some books, be careful, brothers and sisters, you'll find people, some du'at maybe, some da'i, Islamic writers, they accuse and they criticize Uthman. SubhanAllah. One of the great four companions, they criticize him. And they believe, yes, Uthman was this, Uthman was that. SubhanAllah. They accuse Uthman رضي الله تعالى عنه because He started the second adhan. Jum'ah, during the time of Rasulullah, alayhi salatu wasalam, Abu Bakr Umar, also at the beginning of the time of Uthman, one adhan. But at the time of Uthman, he made the second adhan. Okay, this is number one. This is a fiqh issue. So if you have a khilaf, a fiqh issue, you go and you kill your brother. If you have different opinions, different, this is Shafi and this is Hanafi. I kill him because he has a different opinion. It's not right. It's not right. We kill each other and we hate each other because of fiqh issues. This is not right. So number one, this is a fiqh issue. Number two, okay, Uthman radiallahu ta'ala did that, and also many companions agreed with him. It is not an issue to kill Uthman radiallahu ta'ala. You come and you discuss him, no problem. Come and discuss him, but not to kill him. And also they accused him that he prayed four rak'ah for the safar. What is the sunnah when you travel? To shorten the salah, two rak'ah, dhuhr two rak'ah, al-asr, isha two rak'ah. He prayed four rak'ah. He is not following the sunnah. This is a mistake, yalla. You should kill him. Astaghfirullah adhim. Because of fiqh issue, you kill him again. And يعني, the scholar said, why Uthman radiallahu ta'ala prayed four rak'ah in Makkah? Because some scholar said, because he married there someone, so he has a family. If you have two wives, one here in Kuwait, and you have a house, a car, a job, and also you have another wife in another country, and with a house, with a car, so when you go there, don't shorten the salah, because you have a family there and here. So both cities, both countries are your country. So when you go there, so they said the same thing for Uthman. I mean, this is one of the answers from the companions. طيب, and also they said he sent Abu Dhar, he fired Abu Dhar to, he kicked him to a place called Rabada. Subhanallah. And this is also not right. It was the option of Abu Dhar. Yes, Abu Dhar was, he buried there and he died there, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. But not because Uthman forced him and he kicked him out. No, it was his choice. Because of a fiqh issue, Abu Dhar was giving fatwa. If you have extra money than your need, you have to give charity. How much your, for example, how much your salary? My salary 1,000 dinar. What is your need? My need 500 dinar. So you have to give charity the other 500. It is not allowed for you to save one fils. This was fatwa of Abu Dhar, radiallahu ta'ala. The other companions did not agree. Uthman, Muawiyah, they did not agree with him. They said, we are discussing you. If I am paying my zakah, then it's allowed for me to save money. I pay my zakah 2.5% once a year. Khalas, can I save the rest of my money, remaining money? Yes, you can save. Abu Dhar said, no, you have to give charity. If you don't give, يوم يحمى عليها في نار جهنم فتكوى بها جبان, Allah will punish you with this gold. Your face, your side, your back. So, this is as an opinion. You cannot force people to follow your opinion. Can you force people the opinion? I cannot force you. I cannot, I discuss you maybe for 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 1 hour. But at the end, maybe you are not convinced with my opinion. And also, I am not convinced with your opinion. Khalas, what do you like? Khalas. He said, Khalas, I will go away and I will live there. So it was his choice. They said, no, you kicked him out there. And again, this is not right. Subhanallah. So the rumors and people not checking the information led to what? The killing of Uthman radiallahu ta'ala. So please, brothers and sisters, be careful. There are some da'i, maybe famous da'i, nice books, they are writing in a nice way, but they accuse and they criticize the companions in the wrong way. You have to, number one, you have to know the virtues of the companions. And there are certain companions, subhanAllah, you find this deviant da'i, they start from these companions, like Muawiyah, radiallahu anhu, Uthman, radiallahu anhu, Abu Huraira, radiallahu anhu, Amr ibn al-As, radiallahu anhu. Okay, they start from this da'iyah. They start from these companions. Then they start the other companions. So you should be careful. The companions, red line. I have to love all the companions. I have to respect all the companions. they don't do mistakes, they do mistakes, but they have a lot of reward, mountains of reward. This reward will delete their sins, as Sheikh Islam Taymiyyah rahimahullah mentioned. So please be careful. Sometimes maybe the story interesting. Uthman did so, and Talha like this. He did this trick. You should be careful. Don't listen to them. Close this book. Don't read it. Okay. And if you like to know, start with the virtues of the companions. If you like to know, yani people, they like to know in the seerah what happened, why the companions differ. Okay, you can read. Okay. But before that, you have to protect yourself by reading the virtues of the companions. And also, you know, sometimes people like to jump there. They don't know anything about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you ask them, tell me anything about the biography of Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam, he doesn't know. Okay, or she doesn't know. But if you, okay, tell me what about the problem between Ali and Muawiyah? He's ready to speak maybe half an hour or 1 hour. Why? Who's more important, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam or the companions? The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. So subhanAllah, if you study like the way of the scholars, you study the basics. Then you go to the next step. Next step, inshallah, there will not be any problem for you. But where is the problem? When you jump. Okay? You don't know anything about your salah, what are the things which invalidate your wudu, your salah, conditions, salah, the siyam, the zakah, the six pillars of faith. And you jump there, then there is a big problem. You will misunderstand, you will be misguided, and you put yourself at risk. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from the fitan. Jazakumullah khair. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.